Coach,
what you gonna do next in the second quarter?
I don't know. What's that microphone for?
I want to hear what you said, Coach.
I don't think you're hearing something. I don't know.
I can't hear.
Thank you.
focusing problem for me. I don't know exactly what to do.
Thank you.
first basket. Wow, isn't it? Yeah.
Thank you. charge.
Oh yeah, it's charged. It's not. I checked it before I came, and I thought I had a full charge, but apparently I don't. It's not ready.
Move over just a little bit there. It's these bleachers aren't very good. Yeah, getting another set of bleachers, that'll do it. John got his second foul. Now, you can't cut it off from the camera, can you?
Actually, you can. I can cut it off.
Yeah.
Thank you.
see how John does. Yeah, I did. Uh-huh. Your power doing. We're going to take a little break from the action right here. That is it. We'll be back.
Thank you. Thank you. The Tar Heels won all four by a total of 18 points. That Tar Heel team went on to a perfect 32-0 season and the national title. But the Wake Forest team, 1957, had to sit home. They were a great team. 1909, the coach was Murray Greeson. Wake's winningest coach. His record, 288 and 243. And you see the team captains list. The assistant coach in 1957 was, well, Bones McKinney, who now joins Billy Packer as the ACC Sports Center remembers when.
It's hard to believe, Bones, but almost been 30 years since 1957. I mean, we seem to be moving on here a little bit. And even to this day, a lot of people can think about 1957, and the only thing in their mind is Carolina winning the national championship. And people don't realize there was a club called Wake Forest that year that probably gave them the hardest road to hoe they had all year.
Billy, that was some series. Four games we played them. And
now the general public out there, you know, the longer it goes on every year, people say, Wake Forest played them four games that year, and they lost by a total of 5 points. Now, how many points was it?
Well, I couldn't really tell you. I know we lost one game either by 9 or 11, it seems, at Chapel Hill. We lost to them in the ACC tournament by 2 points, I believe.
Okay, it was 18 points in the four games. That was the spread of the four games. Okay. So it was a little bit deeper than what people say. But tell me about one in particular. I always remember when I heard about it, I thought it was the ACC championship in which that Wake Forest club lost to Carolina down the wire. But it was the semifinals, wasn't it?
It was the semifinals. It was, but it was the championship. We had it. Let me tell you the story.
Who was we, first of all? Who made up that 57 Wake Forest team?
Jim Gilley was the center, and Wendell Carr was one forward, and Jack Williams was the other one. And the twins, Ernie Wiggins and Jack Murdoch, were the guards.
One of the great backcourt pairs of all time.
Absolutely. We were behind by 1 point, so we had to go man for man. We'd been playing what we called a 1-1-3. We had to go man for man. And the Cunningham boy, not Billy Cunningham,
Bob
Cunningham, charged Jim Gilley with 26 seconds to go. Now we go to our line with a 1-1. And Jim makes the first one, so we change our defense.
Now, I know Jim. He had to be a little nervous going on the line with us. I mean, Carolina's undefeated at this point, right?
He wasn't a little bit nervous.
How much slapping did you do to get any blood in his face?
Well, you see, one of our rules, Billy, don't talk to the man on the line and tell him we need it. He knows we need it.
So he makes the first one.
He makes the first one. Now, it's a tie ball game, so we go back to our 1-1-3. Tell Murdoch, tell Wiggins. They told everybody but Gilley, because they shouldn't have said anything to Jim. He was just standing there staring at the goal. And he made the second one. Now we're up by one. So I think McGuire's going to call timeout, but he didn't. So Gilley goes down and guards Joe Quigg in the corner. And there's nobody behind. Ernie's fanning Rosenbluth in front. And they lob it over his head, and he drove to his left and drove into Wendell Carr.
Now, you're saying it was a charge, but I don't think history proved that it was a charge.
Well,
he makes the shot.
He made the shot, and they won the ball game. And you know who called the foul?
No, I don't want to talk about referees. We're going to get the referees one of these days. But, of course, that was a game that knocked Wake Forest out, and a lot of people don't realize it. But back in those days, one shot and you were gone. The ACC only had one team that advanced. If you didn't win that ACC tournament, you went nowhere.
Yeah.
And so that Wake Forest club, although they were the toughest opponent Carolina probably had all year, went nowhere. No NIT, no advancement to the NCAA, and of course the great Carolina team.